How many of you in here brush your teeth and wash your hands? All right, it's good to know. Today, I want to tell you about the secrets in soap. Several personal care products like soap, toothpaste, shampoo, cosmetics contain the compounds triclosan and triclocarban, which are used as antibacterials, but they also present several concerns. Let's say after this competition, you go to the bathroom and you wash your hands with antibacterial soap, and without even thinking, you're exposing yourself to these compounds and washing the rest right down the drain to a wastewater treatment plant. Most wastewater treatment plants cannot fully remove these compounds, so they're released into our lakes, streams, and rivers. Here, they are very toxic to aquatic life, killing algae and increasing the deformity rates of fish. They also have hormone-disrupting effects, which can damage the reproductive system because the structures are similar to estrogen and BPA in water bottles. As a lot of our drinking water comes from surface water, when it contains these compounds, it can increase resistance to antibiotic medication, and when treated with chlorine, can produce even more harmful cancer-causing chemicals in our drinking water. This creates a cycle of exposure. This semester, I set out to develop a method to detect these two compounds in personal care products and in water because it's important to know how much we're being exposed to. I used two instruments, the GCMS and the LCMS, and if you're not familiar, you can think of them as bird watchers trying to find and count all of the cardinals in the glen. In this situation, the mass spectrometer is their binoculars, and the cardinals are triclosan and triclocarban. I tweaked the binoculars, so when you look through them, it focuses only on the red-colored feathers, and I prepared the samples, which is like cutting back the foliage in the glen to make it easier to find the birds. Bird watching requires a lot of patience, and right now my samples are running upstairs, but according to my preliminary runs, it looks like the products that have labeled triclosan as an active ingredient will also contain triclocarban, where the products that do not label triclosan will contain neither. This is bad news because we can still be exposed to these compounds, but it's good news because we can distinguish which products have it and which products do not based on their label. So what does this mean for you? I'm not asking you not to wash your hands again, but next time you're buying soap for the kitchen or toothpaste for the family, take a second and read the labels for triclosan. Thank you.